savant with a psychic minute.
Can I say, hello, this is Nino the Mind Boggler with Occult in Your Head. Today, let's get into holes, the most mysterious, importantest, and vaguest subject of them all. The whole Earth might be called a hole if you're on the inside looking out, and whole golden cities might be hid at the bottom of a bottomless pit. Even wholesome humans have holes, though we're hardly whole at all. In fact, we're wholly holy, as the Holy Book says in the Book of Holes, Chapter 1, and they knew not their holes from an ass on the ground. Holes are positively attractive. Let's go inside one and see. This is a typical hole. Not a hole in the wall, but a hole like a well. Well, what the hell? That's the sun at the center of the Earth, and that's where this hole leads to. What a nice warm fire. Next time, I'll think to you about gravity and its opposite, comedy. Till then, this is Nino saying, can I say, goodbye.
Are you going to, well, the happy hour news is back. And what about that big local story, Ray?
Well, thanks, Harold. As some Chinese philosopher said, just dig a hole that's deep enough and everybody will want to jump into it. Well, as you know, that big comet did the digging, and now daredemon Rebus Canibus is going to do the jumping tomorrow morning, weather and authorities permitting. And here's Pat Hat with the story right in our own backyard.
Damn, honey, you ever...
No,
you ever
hold it, hold it. Honey? This is Pat Hat, and I'm here in the desert with Rebus Canibus, here where tomorrow over 210 fine million Americans will turn their 422 million blue eyes upon this man, and it's got to be a fake.
No, this is no fake, Pat. I'm gonna fall into the biggest goddamn hole anybody's ever seen.
He's referring, of course, to the hole that many people says goes directly to the center of the Earth.
That's right, Pat. Now, the only other thing that's been down there before me is that comet.
Aren't you scared, Rebus?
I'm not as scared as you are, Pat. I got the best equipment. I got the special trick shoes and a reverse drag chute.
When will you open the parachute?
Well, I may never get to know that, Pat. They say I may fall into the sun at the center of the Earth.
Or you could go all the way through and be projected into orbit over Kathmandu.
That's why I've got the parachute.
Well, as Sid Fudd, the great scientist sportsman, once said to me, what goes down must come out.
Pat, I'm not down and out. Live or die, I'll make a million.
You're insane, Rebus.
I'm not any more insane than the hundreds and thousands of my fans who come here to help me have the biggest goddamn party the stinking desert's ever seen before I take that jump
tomorrow. Are you worried about
the
weather? There are reports that flash floods are coming along the chilly Colorado. What if the big river floods into the hole?
I'm not worried about that, Pat. It'll either make the hole slicker for me or
it'll put out the sun in the center of the Earth. While I don't want to sanction stupidity as our national sport, still I have to admire this little man's dogged nerve and rubber determination. Yes, it's a small step for this square little fellow, but he's taking a big fall for all mankind. This is Pat Hat here by the big hole at Pachter's Well outside Curio, Arizona.